Hey guys, do you run or are planning to start an online meat delivery, fish delivery or vegetable delivery business? If yes, then in this video I am going to show you a live demo of our advanced ready to use meat delivery solution that we have developed for one of our clients in Canada. Also, you can check out the testimonial video from Ambreen, founder and CTO of Meat Odor, a renowned meat delivery platform in Middle East. Before that, if you need a well-researched business plan, revenue generation plan or marketing strategy on how to start and grow a meat delivery business, check out the link in the description. So in this meat delivery solution, you will get branded ordering website and mobile apps for customers to order meat, fish online, easy to use delivery agent application, vendor dashboard and delivery management system, and a robust admin panel to manage everything from a single place. So in this video, I'll be showing you the live demo of the customer ordering website and the admin panel. To check out a live demo of how the delivery management system or the vendor panel works, check out the video in the suggested video section, or also you can check out the link in the description. So you can see this is the home page of the website. So this is the logo of the brand. If you are buying this white label solution, you can get your own branded logo over here. From here you can change the language of the website. Like you can see, this website is currently available in Spanish and English. You can set the currency for the website, and from the My Account section you can manage your profile or switch to the admin panel. Below that you can see the search bar for where, as a customer, you can search for any particular vendor, product or item that is being sold on this platform. Below the search bar are the meat delivery stores or the meat delivery shops who are selling meat on this platform. Under that you can see the different vendors. Below that you can see the new products. So as a customer, you can order any product or you can order any meat item from here itself. Below that are the on sale products, on the products on which being discounts are given. Below that are the best selling products, and at the bottom you can see the top brands who are offering their products on the platform. So from the quick link section you can register as a meat shop. Suppose if, as a customer, you want to register your meat shop on this platform and sell meat on this platform, you can click on register as meat shop, clicking on which you will be redirected to a new panel where you can upload your personal details such as your name, your phone number, your title, upload the logo and store banner for your store, enter any description, your address, any website and click on submit. Post that, a request would be sent to the admin and he can approve and reject the same. So let me show you how, as a customer, you can order meat on this platform. Suppose if you want to order for this veal stew meat, so you'll just click on the same. Now you can select the quantity, like what quantity you want to order. Now if you want to order it for now, you can click on add to cart, and if you want to save this for later, you can add this to wish list. Below that you can see the product details. You can also read the product description uploaded by the admin or the shop owner. Also you can see the ratings and reviews given by different customers who have already purchased this product. Now if you will click on add to cart, so you can see this product has moved to your cart section. Now let's switch to the cart section, where you can select the delivery address or you can add a new address by clicking on add new address button. Now you can also select your particular location on the Google Maps and you can click on save address. So here you can see the complete order details, such as the item you have ordered for, the price for the item, the quantity you have ordered, the dispatcher or the delivery fees, the subtotal fees and the total amount that you have to pay. Now you get two options that are of schedule and place order for now. Suppose if you want to order this product for now and get it delivered for any time later, you can click on schedule option, clicking on which you can select the date and time for which you want the order to be delivered at, or if you want to order it for now, you just have to click on the place order button. Now you can select the payment options. Currently you can only see cash on delivery option, but from the admin panel you will check out that being an admin, you can add as many payment gateways that you want to integrate. So let's click on place order. So you can see the order has been successfully placed and the order request has been sent to the admin from the admin panel. From this button you can toggle between the light and dark theme of the website, and below that you can see You can download the apps on the Google Play Store and the Apple App Store. And here are the different payment options that are currently available. Now let me show you how can you switch to the admin panel. To switch to the admin panel, you just have to go to the My Account section and click on Control Panel. Now you have been redirected to the admin panel. So starting with the dashboard, from the dashboard, being the business owner, you get a 360 degree view of the entire platform. Like you can see the total number of pending orders, number of active orders, number of orders that have been successfully delivered by you, number of orders that were ordered but cancelled due to n number of reasons, number of vendors, number of categories and products that are being sold, number of banners and promotions being done, how many number of brands are offering their services, and number of return requests initiated by the customers. Below that you can see the sales analytics report, so that being an admin you can keep a track of the total revenue and sales for yearly, weekly or monthly basis. Also these reports are easily downloadable in different formats. Below that you can see the revenue by location and orders by top categories, so that if you want to track a revenue for any particular location, like if you want to analyze in what particular location your business is doing extremely well, you can track down through the revenue by location. And likewise, you can see for what particular items are you getting the most number of orders for. Now let's come to the order section, where you can see the pending orders, active orders, and check out the entire order history. So in the pending orders, you can see this is the order we have just placed now while demonstrating the live demo of the customer website. So being an admin, you can either accept or reject the order. Whenever you click on accept the order, it will move from the pending order section to the active order section. And in the active order section, you can view the entire order details, like what is the product name. Like you see, we have ordered meal stew meat. The quantity, the price, the total amount the customer has to pay, what is the payment mode, the delivery information, and any comment or description entered by the customer while placing the order. Now you can change or update the live status of the order. Like you can see, currently the order is in the accepted stage. When you will click on processing, the same would be reflected on the customer website or the mobile application as well. So like we have selected processing for now. And if you click on refresh, you can see the order status has been updated to processing. Likewise, when the order is ready and out for delivery, you can select out for delivery and the same would reflect on the customer website and applications as well. You can see out for delivery, the order status has been updated. Likewise, being an admin, you can update the live status of the orders. Similarly, you can check out the entire order history for all the orders that have been placed, ordered or cancelled due to any reasons. And from the return request, you can approve or reject the return requests that are initiated by the customers. And now let's come to the vendor section. So here you can see the total vendors or the meat shops that are listed on this website. You can see the total number of products they are selling and total number of active orders they have. Next, you can view their commission percentage, how many products they are selling, their active orders, total number of orders, what type of services are they offering delivery, takeaway or any other. You can edit the action of any listing vendor by clicking on this I button. Now you can see the catalog of this particular vendor, like this vendor Tango Beef is selling these particular products. You can select the order prepare time. You can select whether this vendor would be offering its services 24/7 or not. You can enable or disable the auto accept order algorithm. You can change or update the commission percentage, or you can manage the catalog from here. Likewise, you can update the configuration for the store. And similarly, you can add or update the categories and add-ons. Now let's move on to the accounting section, where you can manage account details for different options, such as account details for your orders, loyalty cards, promo code, taxes, vendors and payout requests. So let me show you accounting for orders. So here you can see the total order value, the total orders that have been placed, total cash that has to be collected, total delivery fees, and you can view the entire order history over here. Similarly, you can view the accounting details for loyalty cards, like what are the type of loyalty cards applied, total loyalty cards earned, total loyalty card spend, number of unique orders. Likewise, the accounting details for promo codes, accounting details for taxes such as GST, CGST, VAT, accounting details for the vendors, and the payout requests that are being generated by the vendors or the delivery agents. From the subscription section, you can manage or update the subscription plans for the customers and the vendors as well. For the customers, you can see there are no live subscription plans, so you can add a new plan by clicking on the add plan button. Now you can upload the plan image, set the title, enter the features, like what features would you offer to the customer when they purchase the subscription plan, the price for it, the frequency, whether it would be on weekly, monthly or yearly basis, and a description. And likewise, you can add or update the subscription plans for the vendors. From the customer section, you can manage the data for all the customers who are using this website or mobile application. Like you can see the customer's name, their wallet, their loyalty points, number of orders they have played, how many active orders they have. You can edit the action of any existing customer. So like, let's say if you want to update a customer as a vendor, suppose there is a customer who wants to sell meat on this platform. You can update the customer details and provide him different access, or make him a sub admin and grant permissions to use the dashboard, the order section, the vendor section, add or manage the banners, promo codes, loyalty cards, etc. And in the product review section, you can view the ratings and reviews given by different customers for different items or any particular vendors on this platform. From the settings, you can change or update the profile settings, such as upload your logo. You can see the short code that would link this panel to the dispatcher panel. You can update the name, email, your company address, your contact number, your country, time zone, etc. From the customized settings, you can choose between the light and dark theme from the platform. You can view and update the date and time format. You can define and update the localization, like you can set the primary language, primary currency, and the same would be reflected on the website and the applications as well. You can set the custom domain, you can integrate different social media accounts, or you can set the nomenclature of the website. Likewise, from the styling section, you can manage the styling. Suppose if you want to change the homepage style of the website, you can do that from here. Let me show it to you. Let's say if you update the homepage style of this website. So you can see the homepage style has been updated. Likewise, you can upload the fav icon, change the primary color or the top header color. Like if you want to change this top header color, you can click on refresh and you can see the top header colors has been upgraded. Likewise, you can upgrade the different styling options that are available over here. Also, you can select whether you want to display the age restriction pop-up or not. In that case, only users above 18 years of age would be able to use this platform. Likewise, you can update the contact us form, you can select the what all you want to display on the homepage sections. From the CMS, you can manage the content that would be displayed on different pages, like what content you want to display on the terms and conditions page, privacy policy page, vendor registration page, etc. Likewise, you can manage the content that would be sent through different emails to the customers and vendors. And from the notifications, you can manage what content you want to send to vendors or the customers through different notifications. Now let's come to the catalog. From the catalog, you can manage the categories. Suppose if you want to add a new category, you can click on the add category button. Now you can upload the category icon, its image, select the parent category. You can select how you want to display it, the name, title, description and keywords for the category. Similarly, you can add the variant to this category, or you can also add new brand to this platform. From the configuration section, you can change or update the configurations. Like if you want to add a store and want to deliver its services in a particular location, you can enable the hyperlocal option and you can select the location in which you want the store to offer its services in. So let's say if you select any particular location for a store, it would be offering its services in that location only. It cannot serve beyond that. Likewise, you can select the last mile delivery and customer support. From the taxes, you can add or manage different taxes. like if you want, like you can see currently there's VAT, like which you can add GST taxes and CGST taxes as per your preferences. From the payment options, you can enable or disable different payment options. Like you can see here currently cash on delivery is enabled. Likewise, you can enable different payment options like PayPal, Stripe, LaserPay, PayStack, PayFast, etc. In addition to these, you can integrate any new payment gateway. For that, just reach out to us through the link in description. And at the last, if you want to partner with any third-party shipping partner like ShipRocket, or if you want to offer your services through third-party delivery agents like LalaMove or any other delivery options that you want to add, you can do that as well. And at the end, moving to the marketing section, you can manage the banners. So the banners also serve as an additional source of revenue for the admins, as they can charge a commission fee from the meat shops or the meat vendors who are selling their products on the website. And in return, you can charge a small commission fee from them for displaying their banners. So you can see there are currently two banners that are live. You can either edit these existing banners or add a new banner by clicking on the add banner button. Now you can upload the banner image, its name, assign it to any category or vendor, and set the banner validity. Likewise, you can add the banners for the mobile applications as well. From the promo code section, you can manage different promo codes. Like currently there are two promo codes that are being offered. You can add a new promo code by clicking the add promo code button. Now you can select what is the promo code type, what is the amount, its validity, what services would the promo code offer, who would be the promo code wearer, whether it would be admin or the vendor, the minimum account, maximum amount, and likewise you can select the all attributes as per your choice. And from the loyalty cards, you can manage the loyalty points. Suppose if a customer purchases any products, he would be awarded with certain loyalty points which he can use to avail discounts and offers on any other order he places later. So this helps maintain the customer retention on the platform. So this is how this meat delivery platform works. Similar is the working for the mobile applications as well. If you want to have a one-on-one demo with our experts, you can reach out to us through the link in description. Also, if you have any doubts related to this meat delivery platform or how this meat delivery solution works, just feel free to contact us anytime. We'll be more than happy to help. Thank you.